of x and remainder r of x in each of these ones. Okay, let us see how we do this. See, g of x is your divisor. I can say that it's your divisor. Okay, the divisor I'm writing on the left hand side as usual, x square minus 2. Okay, now that dividend. The dividend is your t of x, x cube minus 3x square plus 5x minus 3. Okay, now if you look in this equation, right, I should see by doing some math calculations, I should remove out the x cube here, right, by adding over x is your 2 times of x, right. So when I multiply here into x with this equation, the resultant is what is x cube minus 2 times of what is your x. So I should write here 0x square as I am not having an x square term in this equation, right? Minus 2x, let me write here addition. Okay. So now what needs to be done? We will be doing it as usual in the normal division. You need to subtract these two here. So x square is removed out. When I am subtracting this one out, I have left with minus 3x square. Now here subtracting, see here when I'm subtracting these two, this is minus into minus becomes plus 7x, isn't it? So what is left out? Minus 3 is only left out. Okay, now again I'm taking the divisor. Now with the divisor, let us do here into minus 3. So that the resultant is 3x square plus 6 is equals to 0. So this is the resultant of this one. So I am just replacing them on the required area. Then how do I have? Now I am having, see here, as you are having this same symbols here, you need to add up the equations. Now when I am adding up, see here, when I am adding up the equations. Okay, that is, and as I am doing here, minus of 3x. So here what it would become? The resultant is your this one only, so it is 0. Hope this is also clear to everyone, right? So now what is left out? We are left out with your 7x only as usual, and again I am doing a subtraction as I do as we need to do here also subtraction. Now subtraction of this one comes out to be what? Minus 1. Let me write over here minus 3 plus 6 into what? Minus I am doing here. So the resultant is what? Like this, so the resultant is minus 9. Okay, so this is left out as we are having here x square, and this is your big value of x, it is not a divisible, right? So, we did here into minus 3. So, I'm writing here minus 3. So, let me write up everything here. Given equation is your p of x, that is x cube minus 3x square plus 5x minus 3. And g of x is your divisor, that is your x square minus 2, and q of x is your quotient x minus 3, and r of x is your remainder 7x minus 9. Hope this is clear to everyone. Let's see the next one. So if you look in this equation, the divisor is given as x square plus 1 minus x, which divides x to the power 4 minus 3x square plus 4x plus 5 here, right? So when I do this one into the resultant is x to the power of 4 plus x square minus x cube. How do I get that? See here, am into an is equals to a of m plus n. Similarly, x square into x gives rise to x square plus n. Well, because if you are writing like this is equivalent to like this, right? So I can write this one as x cube. Hope this is clear. That's the reason I wrote this one over here, right? So into this one I am writing here. So I need to write x to the power of 4 minus x square minus x cube, right? As we are not having any x cube terms here, let me write the x cube term over here as x cube. Hope this is clear to everyone, right? Means on the above of this, I can write this one here as minus of the resultant is minus 4x square is here as your resultant. Hope this is also clear to everyone, right? So what is left out? This x cube is left out, so I am just writing this x cube over here so that we don't get confused. as I am doing here, as I'll have here plus s cube plus 4x plus I, right? So this is left out. Now I'm taking this divisor again, and now the requirement is here the x cube. So I'm doing this one into x. So the resultant is x cube plus x minus x square. Hope this is clear to everyone, right? So let me write the divided over here. So I'm doing here with into plus times of x, right? Now when I'm doing this one here, what would be the resultant? Let me write here the x cube terms, x cube plus x, and this is your minus x square, isn't it? So this is your plus. I am doing here again directly. What we'll do is we will be subtracting everything again, right? Now subtracting everything again. So when we are subtracting this one here, what would be the resultant of these two? This is what? That is minus 4x square plus x square. So the resultant is what? Minus 3x square. So the resultant over here is what? Is something minus 3x square, right? And here x cube and x cube is removed out. And if you look at these two here, the resultant is what? Plus 3x plus 5, right? Plus 3x plus 5. So this is clear up here, right? So if you look at this, the value of g of x, you are having here x square. As I am, the requirement is also x square, right? So what we will do here is, in the last term here, we will be adding up with some constant term here, okay? So the constant term, which what I will do is minus 3. So here, minus 3. Now, doing this one here, the resultant comes out to be what? Like this, isn't it? So I'm just substituting this the entire equation here. X square, this becomes plus 3x. I'm rearranging the required numbers terms here. Now I need to add up this. So this one, then this one is removed out. Now adding up this, so this is what not added, right? So I'm subtracting here, eventually I'm subtracting here, subtracting the subtraction, this is removed out, and eventually subtracted here. So eventually this one is also removed out. And I'm subtracting this here. The resultant is your 8. Hope this is clear to everyone, right? So I can write at last, I'm writing over here, the remainder as r of x is equivalent to 8, and your q of x is your answer, that is x square plus x minus 3. Okay, so let's look at the third equation over here. Given equation is something like this, that is I'm rearranging the terms, minus x square plus 2 divided by x to the power of 4 minus 5x and 6. Now, if you look at this term here, the requirement is x to the power of 4. So, I am doing here x square. So, the resultant is minus x to the power of 4 plus 2x square, right? But, what is required here? We require here some addition term here. And I am doing here into minus. The resultant is something like this, right? So, let me write it here as minus x square. So, this becomes as minus x to the power of 4. Minus 2x square, as we are not having the x square term here, let me write it somewhere here, okay? 2x square, so that I can write the above one as like this, okay? It's equated out. So I'm subtracting this one out, this and this is removed out of the direct line, right? So what is left out when I'm subtracting this one here, this one and this comes out to be your x square, and the rest is written over here as it is. Hope this is clear to everyone, right? So I'm taking this constant term again. So you require here x square, and x square is already over there. So what I'll do is I'll do here with minus 2. So the resultant is a 2x square minus 4. Hope this is clear up to here, right? So this is minus 2 here, right? So what was the resultant? The resultant is something like this, right? Now when I'm subtracting this one out, this and this one out, now I'm subtracting it's left out. So I'll eliminate this. Now again subtracted here, this becomes plus n here. Hope this is clear. So the remainder is minus 5x plus 10, and your quotient is there, that's your required answer is this one. Hope this is clear to everyone, right? Okay, let's look at the next one. Check in which case the first polynomial is a factor of the second polynomial by dividing second by your first one. That is the second one equation, isn't it? So let me take up this part here. I have this in the g of x. If you look at this equation here, I required e to the power of 4. So I'll do these two into. Hope this is clear. But if you're looking at this one here, you are having some number. Let me add this number over here also, so that the equation is balanced out. So this is 2 to the power of 4 minus x times of a square. Hope this is clear. So we are doing into with this term here, right? So the resultant is written as something like this, minus a 6 to the power of a square. Hope this is clear to everyone, right? So I'm subtracting, this is removed out, and this is left out as it is. So let me write the left out terms. And here also, when I'm doing a minus, so that this becomes what? This becomes here, part here, so that at last I can write here plus 4 a square, right? And whatever is left out, I wrote it as it is. Hope this is clear. So similarly, the next time I'm taking this thing here, the required thing is a square, and you are having some number 3. So let me do it into 3t, right? So here I should write plus 3t. So when I'm doing this here, let me write it directly, 3t cube, right, minus 90, and you need to subtract this one also. When you subtract this one is removed out, and 4t square is left out as it is, and 8t is also removed, and minus 12 is left out as it is, right? So if you look at this equation again, t square minus 3, see the required term is your 3, but what is missing? 4 is missing. So let me add up here plus 4, so that the resultant becomes as to be 4t square minus 12. Obviously, now when I'm doing some subtraction, remove out and subtraction, so that this becomes also 0. So I can say that r of x becomes what? 0. If r of x is becoming as 0, then I can say that, therefore, I can say that clearly that t square minus 3. Okay, I can say clearly that t square minus 3 is a factor of. Is a factor of the equation, that is 2t to the power of 4 plus 3t cube minus 2t square minus 9t and well, equivalent to 0. Hope this is clear to everyone. So let's look at the next bit similar like this. Okay, similarly, if you look at the next bit also over here, so the divisor is 3x plus 1, and the equation which you need to divide is something like this. Right. So if you look at the divisor, I am having x square plus 3x plus 1. So the required term is 3x to the power of what? 4. So I should do here x square, right? So this is 3x square. Then directly doing this one into is your this term, isn't it? You have 3x square. Okay. So let me write it over here carefully. 3x to the power of 4 plus 9x cube plus 3x square. Hope this is clear to everyone, right? So I'm doing here subtraction. This one is removed and subtracted here, so I'll have a negative number like this. Now when I'm subtracting this one here, this becomes as minus 10x square. Hope this is clear to everyone. And this is left out, isn't it? So this is left out as it is, right? This is your value of x. So let me write the equation again, x square plus 3x plus 1. Now in the next term, what are lowest? Minus of 4x. So I should write here minus 4x. When I'm doing this one into this left hand, x cube minus 12x square minus 4x. So this is clear to everyone. So let me write it carefully over here, 4x cube minus 12x square minus 4x. So this is clear to everyone, right? So when I'm doing here subtraction, so this becomes here addition. So this and this removed out. When I'm becoming here subtraction, so that it becomes addition. So here this is left out as 2x square and subtracted here, so that this becomes what? 6x. That's 2 is left out as it is. So I wrote this one as it is, right? So if you look in the equation again, that is x square plus 3x plus 1. Now I need to do here into 2, right? So let me write the quotient as plus 2. If I do that into, the resultant is this one, right? So I am subtracting, everything is cancelled out, and the remainder is 0. So if you are having the remainder r of x as to be 0, then I can say that what can be said here? Therefore, x square plus 3x plus 1 is a factor. It is a factor. It is a factor of the given polynomial, that is your given poly here is this one. Hope this is clear to everyone, right? So let us look at the third bit over here. Let us look at the third bit. See, this is your divisor. Let me write the divisor here completely. And this is your dividend. Plus 3x plus 1. Hope this is clear to everyone. So let me write this one over here. 3x plus 1. The required thing is x to the power of 5. So I should write here into x squared. I should do this, right? So when I'm doing this equation into x squared, let me write it here x squared. The resultant is what? The resultant is x to the power of 5 minus 3x cubed plus x squared is your resultant. So let me write the resultant over here also as it is, right? Carefully, that too, okay? Plus your x squared. Hope this is clear. Now I'm subtracting this one and this one is left out, and when I'm subtracting these two here, we are left out with only what? Minus 3. Hope this is clear to everyone. Then this is removed out. Plus 3x plus 1. Hope this is clear. Now, if you look in the equation is this one, the equation is a divisor, right? We're having an x cube term. The required thing is also an x cube term. So, I should do here into so the remainder r of x is how much? 2 here, right? As the remainder should be equivalent to 0, as it is not equal to 0, I can write here directly as x cube minus 3x plus 1 is what? It is not a factor of the given a of x, that is x to the power of 5 minus 4x cube plus x square plus the x is equivalent to 5 by 3. Hope this is clear to everyone, right? So when I'm equating this to 0, when I should equate this to 0, I'm shifting this one to the other side so that I have last number. What I have left with only this one is equivalent to 0, and similarly, I have left with only this equation which is equivalent to 0. Hope this is clear to everyone. This is a factor of the polynomial. Okay, so the first thing what I should do is, if this is a factor of the given polynomial, x to the power of 4 plus 6x cube minus 2x square plus 10x minus, I hope this is understood this. So the first equation, what I'll do is, I'll do this as x square. Hope this is clear. So that I'll have x to the power of 4, right? Let me write the answer here directly. So we are doing it into x square term. So when I'm doing it into x square term, the resultant is 3x to the power of 4 minus 5x square. Hope this is clear to everyone. So when I'm subtracting this, this one is left out, and eventually x cube term I need to write. I'm subtracting this, I have left with like this. Now minus whatever is left out, I have written it, right? So similarly, let me write this g of x into the required thing is your x cube. So what I'll do here is, I'll do into x, right? But if you look at that, you're having 6x square, right? So if you look at this, you're having 3. So into I should do here with what number? 2x. So plus 2 times of x. So let me write the equation here directly. X cube. The resultant of this one becomes as something like this, isn't it? Now again, I'm subtracting this. This one and this one is removed out. So we are left out with what? Minus x square. And eventually this one is separate when I'm subtracting here. And this one is left out, right? So eventually, if you're looking at this two here, this is your required equation, right? So I should do here what? Into 1. So that's the reason I wrote here plus 1. Obviously, x squared minus 5. So then you're subtracting this is your subtracting this is also remote. So the remainder is your 0, right? Obviously, this is clear. Up to here, it is clear, right? So now, let me write some termings here. That is your first bit. A. Your first term. First term coefficient, that's a q of x, is what? I should divide the equation completely, isn't it? So that this is your equation. Hope you got it. So let's look at the second term here. The second term of your q of x. So I should divide here 3x squared by, I think this is your x cube, right? That is the term, yeah. And again, here with what? 3x squared. So the resultant is how much? 2x squared. Hope this is also clear. Similarly, what would be the third term of your coefficient of q of x? If you are absorbing the third term is 3x squared by 3x squared. That is equivalent to 1 only. Hope this is clear to everyone, right? I can write the equation, and I'm rearranging the equation, that is, I'm rearranging the equation as such as to be. So this is your required equation, right? So that's it. X square plus 2x square plus 1. Hope this is clear to everyone, right? So if you are looking at it, so if you are absorbing this, this is in the format of a plus b to the whole square, so that I can write this one as like this. So when I'm writing this one as like this, minus 1 and 1 are the zeros of the equation, isn't it? So at last, I can say that zeros of the equation is r pi by 3 minus root of pi by 3, 1 and minus 1. So this is clear to everyone. These are the roots of the required equation. Okay. So let us look at the fourth one and let's see what to do with this. On dividing this equation by some g of x, the quotient and remainder where? Okay, now he is asking you what is your g of x. So this is clear to everyone, right? If you remember the formulas, okay, this is your g of x and the quotient and remainder. So this is your quotient and this is your remainder, right? So what would be the equation? G of x is equivalent to quotient into your divisor plus remainder. Hope you remember this. This is your Laplace division algorithm. A is equivalent to bq plus r. Okay. So I'm just substituting them over here so that I would get g of x, right? When I'm substituting all this, that is your g of x. G of x is your required equation. The equation is x cube minus 3x square plus x plus 2 is equivalent to q of x is your x minus 2. You need to remove g of x plus your r of x. R of x is what? Minus 2x plus 4. Oh, this is clear up to here. It's clear, right? So let's see, how do we do this? I'm shifting this term to the other side. So when I'm shifting that term to the other side, I have left with only this term. So this is clear to everyone. So that this becomes plus 2x minus 4 is equal to x minus 2 into g of x. So this is clear, right? Good. So then I'm solving this. Let me solve this one first so that there won't be any confusion at all. When I'm solving this one out, I will have put x cube minus 3x square plus adding up these two is your 3x. So minus 2, okay, is equal to, now shifting this one to the other side. When I'm shifting that one to the other side, it's a divisor, right? So this is your g of x. Now he is asking you to remove g of x only. So that is what we need to do here, right? So let me divide that equation. X minus 2 is your divisor by, we are having here x cube minus 3x square plus 3x minus 2. So let us do this back here. When I do this here into x square, right? The resultant is x square minus 2 times of x square, isn't it? Now when I'm subtracting this one out, this way, so subtracting of these two comes out here, minus x square plus 3 times of x minus 2. Now I need to do here minus of x only, right? When I'm doing this one here, minus of x, this is what I get as the resultant. Now this is subtracted out, so this is removed directly. So subtracted out, so when I subtract that, I have left with x minus 2 only. Now I need to do this into 1. So into 1 would be your x minus 2. I'm subtracting out, I left with only 0. Hope this is clear, right? So what would be the equation that we've obtained? So I can write that g of x is your required equation, that is x squared plus 1. Hope this is clear to everyone. So let's move forward. Okay, now he's asking you to give some examples of this equation. You are having some R of x, g of x, q of x, and p of x, right? Which satisfy the division algorithm as in the given situation. So this should be your required equation. And then won't ask this in the examination. So I'm giving this as a homework for you. Just divide this and say that if you have a question, you can write any example equation as such, okay, and some other degree equation is 2x square, let me write plus 8x plus 24. So if you're looking at this, these are the multiples on the same level, okay. So when you're dividing, right, the remainder should be, when you're dividing this one out, the remainder should be is equal to 0. Remember that one as well, okay. Now if you're looking at the next one here, you should require a quotient and a degree, the degree of these two should be equivalent. So you need to take one equation, that is your p of x is x to the power of 5 plus 2x to the power of 4 plus 3x cubed plus 5x square plus 2. Hope this is clear, right? Similarly, q of x, I have taken this equation, right? It's of m degree. The next one is r of x should be, the divisor should be, the remainder should be is equivalent to 0. Hope you will get this. So let's see how do we do this. The remainder should be is equivalent to 0, right? So if the remainder r of x is equivalent to 0, that is the degree of r of x should be is equivalent to 0, right? So let me take r of x as to be 2, okay, and p of x as a given equation is 2x to the power of 4 plus 8x cubed plus 6x square plus 4x plus 12. Well, this is clear to everyone, right? So this is your q of x. I'm taking this now as r of x. That is as q of x and divide this equation. So the degree of r of x will be is equivalent to 0 all the time. Hope this is clear to everyone, right?